Hello friends, it's good to be back here. You're welcome to another lesson. For sure, this lesson is not going to make you run away, right? I can imagine that, right? The last time you ran away from class, you know the feeling, my friends. Of course, this is going to be exciting, entertaining, and of course, educative. Today, we're going to be talking about an interesting topic, and that is, what is Bitcoin? Sounds common, right? And of course, at the end of this lesson, I hope you will understand better what Bitcoin is, of course, how Bitcoin works, what's Bitcoin mining, how it works, and of course, most importantly, Bitcoin trading and investing. Of course, that's where the money is, right? All right, without boring you with more details, let's just go straight. But before we do, friends, nothing you find in this video is a financial, legal, or tax advice. Do your own research always. Bitcoin, friends, let's get started. Bitcoin is a digital currency created in January 2009 by a person or group of persons known as Satoshi Nakamoto. Right? Sounds familiar again. Of course, friends, Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency because it uses cryptography. Cryptography? That's huge terminology, right? What does that even mean? Cryptography is simply communication techniques that allow only the sender and intended recipient of a message view it. Right? It can also be seen as a science of making and breaking codes. Science of making and breaking code. Stay with me, friends. You have a better understanding soon. And of course, Bitcoin and cryptography. What is the relationship? I'm sure it will make sense to find out, right? Yeah, it will. Recall I said earlier, Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency because it uses cryptography. Yeah, right? It will help to think of cryptography as Bitcoin security because it helps secure communication between sender and receiver on the Bitcoin network. Okay? And now, the Bitcoin network relies on the most common use of cryptography system. Right? And what is this common use, if you may ask? Now, let's talk about the cryptography system or method in question. They are symmetric or secret key and asymmetric or public key system. Terminology, right? Because stay with me, friends. Symmetric or secret key, this system encodes a message with a secret key, right? Both the encoded message and the secret key is then sent to the recipient for decryption, right? Now, think of decryption as used here as simply opening an envelope to see its content. Clear enough, I guess, right? I'm sure you're thinking, but Mr. Whatever, if both message and secret key is sent, how does it ensure security? Intelligent question, my friends. Of course, this is a problem associated with this method. Hence, cryptologists devise asymmetric or public key. In this case, the communication parties have one public and one private key, right? Here, the sender requests for the recipient public key, encodes the message, and send it along, right? By so doing, only the recipient can access the message using a private key, right? Of course, this eliminates the possibility of a third party interception, as might be the case of symmetric or secret key method earlier talked about, right? I believe this is clear. Okay, now that we already mentioned public and private keys, Let me quickly highlight the difference, right? Now, public key is a wallet identity that everyone sees without security compromise, right? While private key, on the other hand, is a wallet identity only the owner should know. Only the owner, my friends. Never ever share this key with anyone. I emphasize, never ever. All right, friends, before the end of this session, I'm sure you will know why. With that said, friends, how does Bitcoin network work? How does Bitcoin network work? Right, as contained in the white paper Fed shared among cryptographers in October 2008, the author or author, as the case may be, suggests a peer-to-peer electronic cash system that should completely eliminate third parties. Right now, third parties includes government or banks, but not limited though, as of course Mr. Whatever can be classified a third party as long as the transaction requires my consent. All right, friends, enough of terminology. Let's try pictorial illustration. Stay with me, friends. I believe everyone can see my sketching, right? By the way, don't mind my sketching. All right, friends, that's just by the way, right? Bitcoin, right? And of course, blockchain, block, Peter, miners, John, authorities, and banks, right? And of course, here is a simple illustration of our Bitcoin network work. Now, this guy here, Peter, has some Bitcoin that, of course, John here needs, right? Now, for Peter to get this Bitcoin across to John, he obviously needs John's public wallet, as I mentioned earlier. Of course, John can only provide his public wallet, right? With Peter having full access to his private and public wallet, or probably if he's using exchange, only access to public wallet. Of course, we'll get to that shortly. Peter can move his Bitcoin to John using the Bitcoin network, and this basically go through directly from Peter to John without third party, right? Of course, that's the question of controversy. I'll come to that shortly. Unlike the traditional bank, right? I'm sure you're used to traditional bank that, you know, your transaction has to go through authorities and of course other banks if necessary before your money can get to John. But in the case of Bitcoin network, it goes basically to John, although through the intervention of miners who are there to verify these transactions. Right now, let me just try to make a distinction between central authority being a third party in this transaction and of course miners not being a central authority, as the case may be. Of course, they are middlemen, right? Because they are required to verify this transaction, but they have little or no authority to either stop this transaction or reverse this transaction, as the case may be. The communication here is basically between Peter and John, right? Peter has made his ultimate decision to send money to John. No miners have the authority to say, hey, Peter, don't send money to John. Of course, we are trying to verify John and all that and all that. All the miners has the authority to do is to check the wallet of Peter to know if Peter truly has enough balance to send to John, right? And of course, if the computing process match enough balance for Peter, the transaction goes smoothly. I believe that is clear enough. So friends, that is just by the way. Now, the miners here simply verify the transaction, add it to block, right? And of course, when the block is filled, it's added to blockchain. Please, friends, I have a video that I will link below, of course, also at the end of this video on blockchain. I did simplified everything you should know about blockchain. It will really help you a lot. All right, friends, I hope this is simplified enough. And of course, friends, we will appreciate your thoughts in the comment section below. Let's know what you think. Let's know if you have a better explanation to this. It will really help us moving forward. Before we proceed to answering another burning question, let's read a piece published on bitcoin.org right now. The blockchain is a shared public ledger on which the entire Bitcoin network relies. All confirmed transactions are added in the blockchain. It allows Bitcoin wallets to calculate their spendable balance so that new transactions can be verified, thereby ensuring they are actually owned by the spender. The integrity and the chronological order of the blockchain are enforced with cryptography. Of course, in our earlier illustration, this obviously is Peter, and of course, this is John. Peter wants to move some coin from his wallet to John's wallet. And of course, friends, a transaction is a transfer of value between Bitcoin wallets that gets included in the blockchain. Bitcoin wallets keep a secret piece of data called a private key or seed, which is used to sign transaction, providing a mathematically proof that they have come from the owner of the wallet. The signature also prevents the transaction from being altered by anybody once it has been issued. All transactions are broadcast to the network and usually begin to be confirmed within 10 to 20 minutes through a process called mining. Of course, we will get to that shortly. I have no doubt everyone is on the same page. If not, leave a comment below. Let's know your thought. Okay, let's move on. During the illustration, I did mention miners who validate transactions. Now, I'm sure you want to learn more about them. This brings us to the next burning question, and that is, what is Bitcoin mining and how does it work? Right? So, Bitcoin mining is the process of adding new transactions to the Bitcoin blockchain. Right, people who mine Bitcoin use a process called proof of work, that is, deploying computers in a race to solve mathematical puzzles that verify transactions. Right, sounds a bit technical, right? Of course, this obviously difficult job is not without a reward, or rewards as the case may be. Now, the new Bitcoin added to the network happens to be the miner's reward, and this reduces with every halving event. I guess you've heard the words Bitcoin halving event, right? This is a ritual held about every 4 years that reduces Bitcoin miner's reward. Let's see a graph of the halving, right? And of course, read a piece published on Investopedia. Stay with me, friends. Here is the graphical representation of Bitcoin mining. When Bitcoin mining first started, miners' reward was 50, right? That's when the first Genesis block was mined by Satoshi Nakamoto himself, right? The reward was 50. But after the first halving, the reward dropped from 50 to 25, right? At around 2013 to 2016. And of course, my friends, the reward for that dropped from 25 to 12.5 from 2007 to 2020. And of course, currently the reward is 6.25. So my friends, the difficulty keeps increasing, and of course the reward for miners keep decreasing. We'll talk more about that shortly. All right, let's read a page from Investopedia. Bitcoin mining is the process by which Bitcoin is released into circulation. Generally, mining requires solving computationally difficult puzzles to discover a new block, which is added to the blockchain. Bitcoin mining adds and verifies transaction records across the network. Miners are rewarded with some Bitcoin. The reward is halved every 210,000 blocks. The block reward was 50 new Bitcoins in 2009. On May 11, 2020, the third halving occurred, bringing the reward for each block discovery down to 6.25 Bitcoins. So friends, I hope that's clear enough. And of course, it will be interesting for you to know that by the year 2140, it is estimated that all Bitcoin have entered circulation. That is, the 21 million Bitcoin must have been mined, and meaning mining will release no new coins, right? And of course, miners may instead have to rely on transaction fees. Can transaction fees sustain miners when all Bitcoins have been entered into circulation? Who knows? That's the question. Hopefully we'll find answer to sometime in the future. Hey, Mr. Whatever, enough of this boring stuff. Show me where the money is. I'm sure your inner mind is echoing this already, right? Calm down, friends. Calm down. Bitcoin trading and investing. But before we go further to explaining, it will make sense to first understand what trading and investing means, as most people often interpret these words to mean the same thing, although they share similarity. Now, of course, trading is simply buying and selling assets for short-term gain, right? Traders jump in and out of assets within weeks, days, or even minutes. While on the other hand, investing is buying and selling assets for long-term gain, usually months or years, as the case may be. Getting started with Bitcoin trading or investment is simple, in my opinion. Just a quick one. Bitcoin can be bought or sold either via decentralized exchange desk or centralized exchange sales. Detailed difference is beyond the scope of this lesson. However, desks are simply exchanges without central regulations, right? Like other books or automated market makers, AMM, etc. And of course, sales are exchanges with central regulations like Binance, Huobi, Coinbase, etc. That is just by the way. Nice starting point for Bitcoin will be coin market cap. So friends, this is the coin market cap I did mention, coinmarketcap.com. On coin market cap, you can just head to the search section, and that is located here, right? And of course, on getting here, you simply need to search for Bitcoin, right, friends? Bitcoin. And of course, if it opens up, you find the current circulating supply of Bitcoin, as obvious here, right? Current circulating supply of Bitcoin. Of course, if you're interested, yeah, you can let the mass supply, the total supply, and of course Bitcoin price. Of course, friends, you can learn more detail, the current watch, those who have added Bitcoin to their current watch list, of course, the market cap, And a lot of stuff truly you can learn here if you are interested. But the session I am particular about at this point is the market session. The market session is the session where you get details of exchanges trading the particular coin, in this case Bitcoin. And of course Binance of course had the largest in terms of trading volume, right? Of course Coinbase exchange, Hobo Global, FTS, of course Binance USD. So friends, there are basically tons of places and exchanges you can get this 100 right number that you can get Bitcoin, right? What you need to do is to find out if these exchanges are allowed to operate in your location. In my case, I would like to go with Binance or KuCoin. Of course, the exchanges I mentioned are allowed to operate in my jurisdiction. Please, if you would like to sign up with my link, I would gladly appreciate it. And of course, it comes with benefit. You have a reasonable discount in fee, and of course, sometime bonuses. All right, friends, that is just by the way, friends. After making a choice of exchange that you would like to go with, right, complete the sign up process to enable you get a wallet address. Mind you, this wallet provided by said exchanges does not give you private key. Recall we briefly talked about private and public keys, right? Now, to have full access to private and public keys, you will need a cold or hard wallet, also known as decentralized wallet. It can be either hardware like Ledger, Trezor, etc., or blockchain powered applications like Trust Wallet, MetaMask, Coinbase Wallet, etc. Right now, the private key can be a random number, an alphabet that is often complex to guess. Right? Also, the private key can be in a seed format, right? That is, of course, not too easy to guess. Of course, friends, let me just show you examples of this wallet, right? Okay, now, friends, this is a Bitcoin wallet, right? You're welcome to your wallet, right? Friends, disclaimer, this is not my wallet, and of course, I don't expect you to interact with this wallet at all. This is just for illustration purpose. So, this is the wallet address, right? And of course, this wallet has this current balance. Of course, this is the barcode for the wallet, right? And of course, this is the send key. If the wallet need to send that, of course, if the wallet need to buy, of course, if the wallet need to sell. Of course, the wallet can also take a look at history, etc. So that is just by the way. And of course, friends, here also is another example, Bitcoin wallet, the private key, and of course the public key, right? Now, the public key is what you provide to anybody, and you provide it in the form of your address, right? Of course, when you do that, they are not going to get access to your private key, right? Of course, it's another example. This is the public key, right? This is the public key. There's the wallet, the private key. There's the wallet, friends. And of course, you can clearly see, do not lose or share this private key. If you lose this, friends, it's not gonna be easy for you to get access to your Bitcoin. Of course, this is just an example, friends. Private key can also be in a seed form, right? A 12 word randomly chosen, right, that you can only have access to, right? It can be used to restore your wallet whenever you need to, right? And of course, here's another example. Here is a 24 seed phrase example. All right, friends, that is it. I believe that's clear enough, right? Now that you know a bit about wallets, You can send BTC from exchange to cold wallet or hard wallet anytime. Right? That is it, friends. I hope you find value in this lesson. Of course, if you do, smash the like button for me. Of course, subscribe to this channel to get more of this kind of lesson. Turn on the notification bell to get all important information. I really appreciate your time. I can't thank you enough. Of course, friends, share this video with your friends, family, neighbor, and of course, whatever. Hope to see you in the next lesson. Bye-bye.